Es jūs gribu iepazīstināt ar Slow Food pavāru Elēnu. Un mēs kopā gatavosim vienu speciālu zupu, kas šajā gada laikā tikai tad, kad olīva tiek novākts, viņš šo te zupu gatavo. Tā ir rudens ziemas zupa, zupa a la Frantoiano. My correction is good?
Yes. This is the principal ingredients to prepare the zupa alla Frantoiano. Allora, we have the beans. We must boil these beans and then prepare a sort of potage.
Yes.
And in this potage, we cooked the other vegetable and herbs that are very, these herbs, for example, are very important to prepare the zuppa alla Frantoiano.
And you have 14, maybe 15.
Yes.
15 herbs
here. In this season, with the rain, it's not easy.
Collect them, yes. And this is nearly all wild, yes? Most of them are wild.
Yes.
Yeah.
But for example, in December, when arrived the very winter,
yes.
There is a lot of herbs and they are very, very good to prepare this soup.
Yes. But then you still have
and
some.
The sage
and the rosemary.
Yes. This il lardo, yeah. And the
garlic.
Yeah. And then there are the other vegetables.
Uh-huh.
That there is not like this herb is cultivated.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. There is the black cabbage.
Uh-huh.
The beet.
Yes.
The persil.
Parsley.
And the white
cabbage.
Cavolo cappuccio. And then there is the zucca, pumpkin. The zucchino.
Zucchini.
The fennel. Yes. And the sedano. Celery, carrots, and then different sort of onion, because I use the red onion of Lucca, that is this, and then porro, I don't remember the name in English.
Leek, purav.
And then another sort of onion that is a fresh onion, white.
So you have 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, quickly I counted.
Yes, okay.
38, wow. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, and now we have...
You can't send your husband out with a shopping list for 38. He doesn't come back for 2 weeks.
In the soup of Frantoiano, use only extra virgin olive oil.
Of course.
Just not other sort of oil.
This is now just pressed.
Yes. And then we add the onion.
Onion and the leek.
I prefer the soffritto.
Uh-huh.
It's the part of the soup
onion and
with
tomato.
The lardo, rosemary, sage, and garlic.
Uh-huh.
It's very, very good. It's very good because there is the herbs.
Yes.
And then I add the extra virgin olive oil. And then I cook the soffritto, and then I use only the oil.
Because the flavor has gone into the oil.
And I put this in the soup. It's important that the lardo is not very browning.
Yes, it
is not good. And then we add the other vegetable, celery, zucchini, pumpkin. This soup is different, not in every country, but in every family.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
For
everyone makes a difference.
This is the recipe of my grandmother.
Yes.
And is my recipe.
Uh-huh. Now it's yours. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's typical of Luca, but it's typical of my family.
Yeah.
Also.
Okay.
Not very much, because then there is the lardo.
Of course, which is salty.
Yes.
Yeah.
Do you want to cut this?
Yes,
Okay.
Yes.
Not very thin.
Rough.
Yes.
Quite rough.
Mira Napoli e poi mora.
Edge.
Uh-huh.
The beans.
So the beans are all in here, but I don't see the bean itself.
No.
What has happened to the bean?
Yes.
It's been pressed.
Pressed with the
Ah, yes. Just like the olive oil. Yes.
Yes. Similar.
Yeah.
Now we add the tomato.
Mm-hmm. Paste. Like.
Like this, yes. Mm-hmm. Now we can use only, the oil.
Mm-hmm.
And so, yes. And I must cook this for an hour, and the final soup is like this.
Aha! You are one step ahead of the camera. Aha!
This soup is served with the bread.
So this is the traditional way that you serve the soup, the bread, the day-old bread, or maybe 3-4 days old bread.
Yes.
And voila. Oh. And then the olive oil.
Maritare, figlia mia, te chi tu dare, mamma mia, pensaci tu. C'è